Hello and welcome. My name is Kevin Atard Compagno, and in this video we shall be talking about port forwarding, when to use this with 3CX phone system, what issues are caused by incorrectly configured port forwarding, and how to troubleshoot such issues. Before we delve into the details, let's first take a look at when port forwarding is required. 3CX phone system is installed within the local area network of the organization. The LAN is generally protected from the internet using a firewall, so it is the firewall that decides which connections from the internet are allowed through. The firewall will often act as a router between the internet and the LAN, so it knows where connections need to be routed. Whenever you need to connect to the PBX from the internet, you must configure your firewall to allow such connections and to forward the connections to the PBX. This is known as port forwarding, and the configuration steps depend on the model of the firewall device. This means that you must configure port forwarding when you are using either a VoIP provider connection or bridge connections or remote extensions. Let's take a quick look at the ports that might need to be forwarded. Remember that you may not need to configure port forwarding for all of these ports. For example, if you are not using remote extensions, bridges or VoIP providers, you do not need to configure port forwarding at all. The most important ports are the SIP port, which uses UDP port 5060, and the RTP ports, which use the range of UDP ports 9000 to 9049. These are required for remote extensions and bridged PBXs to register with 3CX phone system, and for calls to be made between the PBX and the remote extensions, the VoIP providers and the bridges. If you are using secure SIP, you need to port forward TCP and UDP port 5061. If you are using the 3CX tunnel protocol, you'll need to port forward TCP and UDP port 5090. You will need to port forward TCP port 5000 if you intend to provision remotely your extensions, configure the PBX remotely, or if you want users to connect to 3CX MyPhone from the internet. The exchange of presence information across bridges requires this as well. Apart from allowing connections from the internet on the mentioned ports, 3CX phone system requires the firewall to route the connections to the PBX. In doing so, the firewall should not change the port numbers, as this might mess up the VoIP connection, resulting in SIP packets with inconsistent data. SIP ALG functionality found in some firewalls sometimes causes this issue. The SIP ALG concept is discussed in other 3CX videos. In this example, the firewall is sitting between the internet and the PBX. It has been configured to forward connections received on specific ports on its public interface to the machine running 3CX phone system. Note that when this happens, the port is not changing. Each router or firewall device has a different management interface. For this example, we will be looking at configuring a DRATEC device. We want to allow VoIP connections for remote extensions over the 3CX tunnel protocol and for VoIP provider accounts. To achieve this, we need to configure port forwarding for UDP port 5060 SIP messages, UDP and TCP port 5090 for the 3CX tunnel protocol, and the UDP port range 9000 to 9049 for RTP audio streams. In this example, 3CX phone system is installed on a server with IP address 192.168.1.200, and the DRATEC is connected to the internet via the WAN-1 interface. To configure the DRATEC, go to the NAT Open Ports menu, and go to the first free position in the Open Ports menu, ensure that Enable Open Ports checkbox is enabled. You can give this a name in the comment field. We will set the WAN interface field to field 1, the local computer field to the IP address of the 3CX phone system machine, and now we can configure the port forwarding entries. So the first entry will be UDP port 5060, the second entry TCP UDP port 5090, and the third entry UDP port range 9000 to 9049. Clicking on the OK button at the bottom of the page saves this. Keep in mind, many WAN to LAN device vendors offer management interfaces which are comparable for most configuration concepts, but do be aware that not all present such an easy-to-understand interface. Always run the firewall checker after you are done to check whether your WAN to LAN device will correctly deliver VoIP traffic towards your 3CX phone system. So what happens when port forwarding is not configured correctly or not configured at all? Connections will be blocked by the firewall or router, resulting in the inability to receive incoming calls from the VoIP provider, indicating that port forwarding is not correctly configured for port 5060. Remote extensions might not be able to register, once again indicating port forwarding issues with port 5060. If port forwarding is not configured correctly for the RTP ports, you could experience one-way or no audio. And you can experience also connection issues to 3CX MyPhone and 3CX Management Console, and the inability to provision extensions remotely if port forwarding for port 5000 hasn't been correctly implemented. The 3CX phone system includes a firewall checker that allows you to confirm that port forwarding is correctly configured for the SIP and RTP ports. Note that the firewall checker requires you to stop the 3CX services. No phone calls can be made while the firewall checker is running. The firewall checker performs two checks. It checks that 3CX is able to make outbound connections using the ports mentioned. This is a very basic check and should not fail. If this check fails, the PBX will not be able to connect to VoIP providers or remote extensions. The second check ensures that computers and the internet can connect to the PBX on the SIP and RTP ports. If this check fails, you will most likely encounter the issues described previously and possibly others. The firewall checker will provide information on the issue that has been encountered, which can be used to aid troubleshooting. More information about the firewall checker can be found in the link shown here. If you have not configured your WAN to LAN device yet, the first time you run the firewall checker, you'll receive a report that shows all the required ports are not correctly configured with port forwarding. Here, we can see a typical report from the firewall checker for a WAN to LAN device that has been partially configured with port forwarding for the SIP port and the 3CX tunnel protocol port, but where the RTP and RTCP port range for audio delivery has not yet been forwarded correctly. Now we have completed the configuration on the WAN to LAN device. All the ports required by 3CX phone system for SIP, tunnel and audio connections are correctly forwarded. This brings us to the conclusion of this video. Please check our other videos at the link provided.